Speak to your people. Remind us of how we ought to contact and believe. Help us, Father, even to our accounts in heaven for those who have and help us to maintain for those who do not have. Bless us now in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Bwana asifiwe. Praise the Lord. This morning, this afternoon, I'm born again. The Lord is my Savior. Since He saved me, I've never regretted walking in this journey of faith, in fear and in trembling, each time helping me to carry my cross, taking it to Him, all my needs and cares. And this morning, I'm happy that He has given me an opportunity to share the Word of God with the theme, Do you have an account in heaven? Do you have an account in heaven? And it's a question. So let me ask, how many have accounts here on earth? And if you don't put your hands up and you have an account, you'll find your money has come to the account of the church. So how many have accounts here on earth? Whichever bank. If it's M-Shwani, I'm going to thank you very much. That is the first question. Now the second question. How many have money in their account? Well, people of God, if you put your hand down and you have account with money, it will come to the church. How many have money in their accounts? Hey, you want to understand that? God has seen those hands and is going to increase, and you have not put it up your hands, you will find your money in the account of SKS and Baptist people. For the word of God, praise God. So we thank God. We all have accounts. And the reading that I will read and use is 1 Chronicles 29:1-5 and Matthew 6:19-24. Praise God. And I want to ask, as a way of introduction, or maybe to bring it as a way of introduction, to let us know of these accounts. We all have treasured possessions ranging from houses, money, gadgets, accessories, clothing, among others. That is a fact. How many have phones here? Treasured phones. People of God. Am I not seeing them? And I always see people walking out to go and if you want to know somebody is going to receive a phone call, you can just watch one day here in church. If it's a mama, he will just take his bag and then rush so quickly like this. Then it will take some time and come back. If it's Amze, you know Amze when I come. It will ring, and then you'll see Amze like this. Eh? That one is going to pick up. Phone. I have observed that one mostly. So if your phone is on, put it on flight mode. It will not disturb you. Praise God. That is if you have a Bible. All of us have got treasured possessions. We have treasured clothes. Just as the way the Bible is saying. And what is coming off all that we have? Maybe you have been blessed with a car, maybe a bicycle, maybe a motorcycle, maybe a watch, precious one. You always want it to be saved, like forever. Like for me, this watch I was given by a friend. I've tried to look for him on Facebook. When I was a student at St. Paul's, they came for exchange program all the way from UK. So he gave me this phone, and it's very expensive. Very expensive, praise God. Yes, I'll not tell you how much. but it's very expensive because it has never gone off. It uses solar power. I have never opened it, and I've stayed for close now to 10 years. Praise God. So it is very precious for me. I know all of us have got some things which are precious so much. Some it is their children, some it is their husbands, some it is their wives. And now we are not talking about the human. We talk now of this tangible, which are not human, but they are very significant and important among us. And as I say, we have special places where we give them. We all need this precious possession to be saved and with increased value rate. For those of us who have got farms or shamba, we want it to have value increasing. Also, if maybe you have something that you would want to sell, which it has been in this condition, you'll have to reshape it and then sell it with an added value. But my focus this day is storage. To be specific, the heavens bank. Praise the Lord. Bwana asifiwe. And I know we've got banks which we believe always that they offer most secure options to keep our money. For all of us, I believe money is what we treasure most. Most of us. That one we cannot lie. Most of us, money is what we treasure most. And you can even see at times, for wazee, when you open a wallet, when they want to give something maybe to mama, how do they always do their give, remove money from the wallet? No, mama mseme, mama mseme. Wanatawa kani pesa? Kwa the wallet you know. Mesema niyamboga. And then our family, yoyo. Lakini wallet, hawezi kuza. And it reminds us of a story. A person had a wallet. Mama kambia saidia pesa ya mboga, kasema sina kabisa, sina. Mama alijua amepata bonus ya mtenichai, sina kabisa, sina. Matinye kabisa, matinye kipondo, bola mamondo kabisa, sina, sina. And then the call of nature called. Na alikuwa na pesa kwa wallet. And then, when you know sometimes these calls come urgently. So this person rushed the washroom and nearly alizaa, yenye mechimbwa chini, akaingia huko. In the midst of trying to open the necessary facilities so that you can do that service promptly, the wallet, whoop, with the money. This man, when he was there, he started saying, "He chose nataka tubomoe, nataka tubomoe choo. He chose nataka tubomoe, mama anaweza nini, tunataka tubomoe choo kapisa kapisa, ni nafikiri si nzuri, tunataka tubomoe," you know. He was remembering what? The money. Mama alimuuliza hana ya mboga, lakini akasema, hakusema, you know when such things happen, you don't want to say how much you have. Hallelujah. So we want this money to be kept safe, and sometimes access is no go zone. But what I'm talking this way is about this heaven account. And before we open accounts, these ordinary accounts, sometimes you are given options. All banks, there are always terms and conditions for opening and operating one. You need to know as you prepare to open an account. And I know all of us were prepared before we open an account. Either Equity Bank, either Family as the Bronze was saying, whether Bank of Africa, all those accounts, even Mshwari Bank, you need to know some terms and conditions. They always say TLC applies. Terms and condition applies. So you need to ask yourselves questions about your preferred banks. And some of the major questions that we always help one, you or me, to open are like this one. Now, one of them is, why do you need a bank account? Of course, the answer is because we have money. Because we have money, that is why we need to have a bank account. Number two, what type of account is best for you? And now that will lead you to which bank is good for you. Remember, I don't have any accounting knowledge, so I'm just trying to gather information and speak. But these are some of the questions that we have always asked. Number three, why do you need to open an account? What are some of the nitty-gritty things that you need before you open an account? For example, and this is where I like most, is some banks will tell, are you this age? Do you have a national ID? You need an opening fee? You need a passport photo. And I like this bit of passport photo. I know all of you have got passport photos, and I was able to access and got like that one. You can see, we had that passport photo. It looks beautiful. It is really beautiful. It is beautiful. Look at you people. There's also that one. It's a passport photo. You can see. It's very good and ready for work. You can see that one also for one of my... These are some of the photos of my youths. There is also another passport photo there. It's a passport photo, you can see. You can also see for the Mujogati passport photo, you can see. And also you have that one. You know, people take photos. You know. Each one of us have got the way we take our photos. Banks will ask you for a passport photo. Question number four. Which you should ask yourself. You need now to ask yourself. Are you required to maintain a monthly? This is now a personal question. Do you require to maintain a monthly minimum balance on the account? What happens if I go below the minimum requirements? If it is a savings account, will you earn any interest? And if so, how much? These are pertinent questions that we always ask ourselves when we open an account. Another thing is, does this account come with a monthly maintenance fee or any other charges such as overdraft fee? Believe me, you don't know what is that. Hello? I think it is over and then the draft and then the fee. I think something like that. So overdraft fee, something that is hidden down there. And now, how can you avoid having to pay any fee? Many accounts will tell you opening this account is free. And that is where now they catch you. When they bring you now the bank statement, they tell you, we removed this, there was this, there was this. I believe that is what we call the overdraft. Those who have done account, overdraft. I think that is something like that. Something like that. Another thing is, are there fees for using an ATM? All of us, or if not all, have got ATM fee, ATM cards. And somebody said that this is called another trouble maker. ATM. Why? Because you go and remove your money, it adds problems. You remove problems. You remove problems. It's like another trouble maker. ATM. That somebody tried to describe. And so you ask yourself, can I be charged if I go to another network? Can we have a joint account for those of us who are couples? Let me not ask that question. Now, with this information at hand, you should now be able to apply and open a bank account that suits you best. That suits you. Now you have the information that this account's like this bank talks like this. Now you can open your account. So you take a step of faith and now go and open your account. But now I want to change focus and go to this account which we call Heaven Account. Praise the Lord. I want to give all of us information about this Heaven Account. And at the end of the day, you will decide if you want to open one, or you will know if you have one, how you are going to maintain that account. Praise the Lord. We want to talk now about the Heaven Account. Praise the Lord. And we are told that in heaven there will be things that will be happening there. And there is this song that says, Hukumu itatolewa kwa watu wale wabaya wapendao ulimwengu na dhambi nao. So you are telling earth bad. Hii ni mara ya mwisho hatutaonana tena dunia ewe dunia kwaheri sana. So what always frightens is siku hiyo kutakuwa na sinema ya ajabu ikionyesha matendo ya kila mmoja. Hapo siku takaka kupita kwa hiyo limo. Heaven Account, your details are there. Praise the Lord. The Bible is clear about our treasures. And Jesus, our spiritual advisor, taught us where we ought to store our treasures. Matthew chapter 6, which he said, we store it where? In heaven. Praise the Lord. We need to store it in heaven. And these are some of the questions and answers that you need to know about this heaven account. And I will be saying them one by one.
What are these requirements that you will need as a Christian to open this account in heaven? Remember, we are all Kenyans. We are all what? Kenyans. But what will distinguish you, when you have an account, is that you will have an account, the other person will not have an account. So there is this distinguishing factor. What are we required? As Christians, very good, we are all Christians. But now the question is, do you have an account in heaven? Sio wote wamwitao Bwana Bwana, sio wote wataingia wapi? Paradiso. You need to have an account in heaven. So what are the requirements to open one? Number one, for you to have it, the requirements are very flexible. Praise God. No passport photo is required. Hallelujah. God knows how fearfully and wonderfully He has made you. In fact, you are made in His image and likeness. Tell your neighbor you look like God. Tell him you look like God. Even if you are young, you look like God. Even if you are old like me, you look like God. You know, people say that when people grow old, they look. How do they look? Yeah. How do old people look? Sijasema kidogo. Yeah, okay, I'm saying. When people grow old, people say, "Ah, sasa." In fact, they cause trouble. When these young ladies look at old people, they start to get scared, forgetting that that old person you are seeing, whether it's a mama or a baba, and many years back, they were very handsome. Hallelujah. Like, I am trying to imagine how handsome our father here, Mr. Sarah, is. And how cute our mother is. Rewind. Today, if you are old, go and look at those old photos. And you realize you are fearfully and wonderfully made. Even the way you look today. What is the person? In heaven, they don't require those features. God knows you. What is the person? God knows you. And in Psalms 139 and 12, He knows you. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. Irrespective of your age, irrespective of your gender. Another thing, we do not require an ID to open this account. Praise God. We do not need identification documents. For He knew you and me even before we were born. Bwana asifiwe sana. Is God amazing? Bwana asifiwe. He knew you and me even before we were born. He had our files. That is what I was coming to. And details way before. Mr. Were, God has your file in heaven. My brother and sister, God has your file in heaven. He has the provost file in heaven. He has all choir members' files in heaven. He knew you even when you were born. He doesn't need introduction of who you are. Praise the Lord. But now, this is the thing. The same files will be used during our judgment day. That's why you're saying, Hukumu itatolewa, watu wote wataona, wapenda ulimwengu na dhambi zao. Hii ni mara ya mwisho, hatutaona tena, dunia ewe dunia, kwa heri sasa. What is scary? Siku hiyo utakuwa, na si mema ya ajabu, kama hizi. Itaonyesha matendo yako na mimi. So if there are things you are doing in secret, you can imagine you are in heaven, control room is up there, wanaweka picha hapo. Wanaona yako, ehe, wanaona, ehe, huyu ni Muse, ehe, ehe, amechukua nini? Sasa hivi umekaa, you are like on the hill, umenyenyekea kiti cha enzi. What is good? This is now the reason why we need to have a heaven account. Praise the Lord. Let's say files will be transferred depending with our BA decision. This is a degree. Hello? And it's called born again degree. Thank you. Praise God. People are wondering what is BA. BA is born again. So if you have the BA, Rest assured that Angel Gabriel will take your file from judgment to everlasting life. Praise be to the Lord. You need to be born again.
What has to your son?
And there will be an opportunity for us to make that decision. Another thing is no age limit. And there is no opening fee. You only need what? B.A. You need a what? Tell your neighbor you need a B.A. certificate. You need a B.A. certificate. And this certificate, brothers and sisters, it is not physical. It is spiritual.
One spiritual.
It is what? Spiritual. You need a B.A. You need to be born again for you to enter this heaven, for you to have this. Another thing about this account in heaven is very good. It has got no maintenance fee. Hello? But you need to work at your salvation every day in prayer, reading the Bible, fellowship, and which will help you to maintain your salvation. Praise the Lord. Read your Bible, pray every day, pray every day, pray every day. Do what? Read your Bible, pray every day. If you want to, if you want to maintain your account, read your Bible, pray every day, fellowship with believers, and you will continue to maintain that heaven account that you opened when you received Jesus Christ. Now, this now applies to all of us who have the B, the what? B, A. Now you have to maintain your account in that manner. A unique thing about this heaven account, it allows you to deposit your fears, your worry, your family, situations in life, relationship, work, let's say everything that you have. What does it mean? This heaven account. It has capacity to access everything that you have. So long as you tell God, God, take over all this that I have. That is now the heaven account. With your deposit, you are assured of everlasting inheritance. Remember, not only are we talking of our life here, our life after we have gone to heaven. Praise be to the Lord. Our brothers and sisters said about that person who passed on immediately after hosting them. For us it was sad, but heaven were happy receiving this person who have fought a good fight. Praise be to the Lord. Our ultimate purpose in life is to make our life ready to be able to go to heaven and see Jesus. One second, son. Well, that's what I've said. It is secured. And we have secured future even more to see the CEO.
What has the previous son?
Who is our CEO? Who? God. God is our CEO. And he sent a managing director. Who is called who? One has the previous son. Imagine that kind of account. You know, some banks, they always have options. We have got teller 1, teller 2, teller 3. And then some quiet corner. It is called for? Bank teller. And also they are called executive deposits. So you, in this ordinary account, if you come with your 200 shillings, you will be told by the security person, go there. Go there. But when an executive person like me comes, they will be told about whether.
There is also tea as you wait to be served. Oh my God. Hey. These are these accounts all
are. In heaven, we are all equal. One as a human. If you have an account in heaven, we are all equal. God treats you and me with equal measure. Jesus knows our worries, our challenges, and deals with them in equal measures. What he requires is for you to have a what? B? What? B A. You need to be born again. In heaven, unfortunately, there is no joint account. Hello? In heaven, let me repeat, there is no joint account. If you Reverend Malimo, it is Reverend Malimo and Malimo alone. If it is Mrs. Reverend Malimo, it is Mrs. Reverend Malimo and Malimo alone. Kila mtu atauchukua mzigo wake.
Hii wimbo hutaki kuimba kwa sababu ni kweli. Unaona umeenda na uchungu sana.
Do you know really how sad that song is? Unasikia kwanza tone yenye ngoro anaimba. Kila mtu atauchukua mzigo wake mwenyewe. Now we are seeing the CEO and the MD. Kila mtu atatoa. Oh Yesu, alalira mwenyewe. Oh, siku hiyo. No joint account, it is you and you alone. But we still have that opportunity for you to have an account in heaven. Be a certificate will be offered immediately after this summer. Don't worry if you don't have. And for you and me who have it, maintain your account. The best thing about this in terms of security, where you can go, you cannot get anywhere on the world, in this world, it is in Matthew chapter 6. 19-24. No thief, no one can ever enter in that account. Bwana asifiwe sana. Whatever you have given to God, nobody will ever access. No hackers, let us talk about technology. Those who hack and then they steal your money can access the heaven database. Praise God. No graft in its operation. No day you hear God say, step aside, you want to investigate the way you stole our client's money. That one is not in heaven, what I say, son. It can never be closed or put into receivership. What I say, people? You have heard of some accounting firms that have been put into receivership. No system failures or upgrade. Right now, Safaricom said, yeah, I'm sorry, you will not be available by God. But in heaven, there is no upgrading. It is always in operation. What is it? It's just amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I was blind, but now I see. My brothers and sisters, the operations of heaven account is 24 hours. Every day, January to December, year out, year in. In Luem saying, Miyakatitie, why is it your son? That is heaven account. Praise the Lord. You can communicate with God anytime that you want, whether it is in the morning, whether it is in the evening. When you go to these other banks, believe me, at 6 o'clock, all of them are closed. Even 6 is early. At 4, they are all closed. And they are now doing the, what we call the returns. For heaven, God's database is out to date. Whenever you deposit your prayer, whenever you deposit your thanksgiving, He takes stock and immediately He updates. And you can still go back and tell God at 9 or at 10 in the night, God, I have this situation. I want you to take care of it. You deposit your prayer needs and you get interest, blessings in answered prayers. One has a few signs. In the same way you get interest in your accounts, when you deposit in heaven, God is going to take care first of everything that you're calling to take care of. And not only that, when now you give, He's going to give back to you. He's the only one who is telling us, no other bank can tell you, if you give or if you deposit, I will give you back full measure, pressed down, shaken together and rolling over. It's only in heaven. Praise be to the Lord. It's only in that account. One has a question. as I finish, God Jehovah Jireh, which means our provider, is the best financial advisor that we'll ever have. He tells us to give and promises the blessings that He will give us back. One as He is now. Give God your worries. He will give you back security and assurance. Praise be to the Lord. He knows what you need. Even today, as we give thanks to the Lord, do not consider the limitless or how small you are or how feeble you are. God always sees the heart. And if today you are saying, God, we have had this call. I want to give a carpet. I want to give a hotpot. Is it hotpot? Was it hotpot closed? What? That hot thing. I want to give toys. I want to, in fact, microwave. Yes. Chinese or Kenyan toilet. In fact, if there's an anger that will please God, it's the one that you say, Provost, tell the people that I am taking care of everything, these things here. That will be a very good anger. It will not be in vain. It is going to come back. Praise Him to the Lord. God will count what you have given. Give Him your family, He will give you peace, love, and joy. Give Him your everything and He will take care of all your treasured position here on earth. Praise be to the Lord. Having an account in heaven is the best decision you can ever make in your life. Open one today if you don't have. And if you have, maintain yours. Praise be to the Lord. I have given you procedure of how to maintain. And you are here today before you finish. You do not have an account in heaven. You want to open one. This is your opportunity now. Remember, there is no other way that your file will be transferred from the other side to this other side. It's unless you have this certificate of CBA, which is spiritual, born again. You will make Jesus your personal friend. You do not have an account in heaven. You want to open one today. This is your opportunity. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and grace. You want to have that account. You want to give your life to Jesus. I want to give you this opportunity. Stand up, we pray with you. And your account is going to be open. Remember, they don't have other requirements. It's only your heart. Oh, what peace we obtain. Stand up and pray with me if you don't have this account. Oh, thank you so much, for sister. Thank you so much for those hands that are giving to Christ. Remember, it's the best decision I've ever seen. And God will help you to maintain this account. And when you have worries, are you weak and helpless? If you want to give your life today to Jesus, thank you so much for the sister for the food. And I know their life is not going to be the same again. Thank you so much. We thank God for these souls that are opening now their accounts in heaven. We praise God for them. And we know that their accounts are going to be active the moment we finish this prayer. Break into thy loving hand. If this answer take a shame. For those who have stood, I want you to say this prayer for me. Say, Lord Jesus. acknowledge our sins. Father, we thank you. You have spoken your word. And you have called us by our names. We give our lives to you today. We denounce every act of evil in our lives. We refuse all the plans of the devil in our lives. And we pray that Jesus, you will walk with me. You will talk with me. Even this account that I have, it will remain active to the day I will see you. Forgive me my sins. Write my name in the book of life. From today, I am your child. Heavenly Father, we thank you because of these dear ones who have given their lives to you. We know that, Father God, there is rejoicing in heaven over those who have repented their sins. And we thank you, dear God, because your mission has been accomplished. Thank you, Almighty God, because you have forgiven them and now they are your children. We pray that Father God will forgive them and will make them now your children. As they start to walk with you, as they have now opened accounts in heaven, we pray that, Lord God, you will help them to maintain them. Help them, Lord, to desire your word. Help them, Lord, to desire fellowship with other believers as they now grow. Thank you because this day will remain memorable in every of their life, Father God. We love you, Jesus, and we glorify your name. Thank you for this soul. Accept them with all pleasure. In the name of God.